problem also now. So this start with your day and divide it into chunks of time. I will be sending you a couple of videos also. So one video, I was really up with a concept called That Girl. That Girl is a concept of a girl who gets everything done. It was started with Radhi Shetty, if you know, wife of Jay Shetty, and I really loved the concept. So I watched a lot of videos to build an ideal routine for me. For you, it might be very personal. So start with the routine and divide it into what will you do from 5:30 to 6:30. And everything here is an idea, is a suggestion, but I would strongly recommend that the first 1 hour of your morning is very, very important. Maximize it as much as possible. So 5:30 to 7, me and Niranjan, my partner, get up in the morning and we start our day with affirmations. That is something that I personally cannot get over with, affirmations. And second is my drinking lime and hot lime and rock salt. These are two habits that are consistent all across it, which is why it's orange. This is something that is no negotiable. I want all of you to pick up one constant habit in the morning. That is what will bring normalcy into your other part. One constant habit. It could be something small, like I will pet my pet, or I would spend time with a book. Something very simple. I would water a plant. Main tulsi ko plant water de dungi. One activity you need to define here. Okay. This is just a spread. I'll teach you other ways to do. This is the most simplest one. That is you, that anybody can do without a scale also. Just write in a day, what is it that you want to do? What is it that you want to do from 5:30 to 6:30, 6:30 to 7, 7 to 10. Okay. Then keep a break for lunch. Divide the whole day. This sounds very kiddish ki ek ek ghante ka we are writing, but in the beginning, this is a great way to start your day. This is a template that I put out, that I took a printout also and I put it because I know exactly what is to be done at what point of the hour. And if you can see, there are different, for my content creation and office work is from 11 to 8. 6 to 6:30 is my house course. So one day it is arrange clothes, second day is clean room, third day is kitchen, fourth day is kitchen, wash clothes, all of it there. Then 9 to 10 to 11 is my unwind thing. So I've given myself 10 to 11 time to either art or to read. Either two of them. Either or one of them I will do. And then the last part of my day is self-care, which is I have allotted for my skincare, for my learning my languages, and 15 minutes for journaling. So here you might ask me, journaling, should we do it in the end of the day or should we do it in the beginning of the day, right? It's a very valid question. I often face the question. It depends on what kind of goals are yours. If you are a person who starts their day comparatively a little late and don't get up in a hurry, morning is a good time for you. Morning may the goal is, when I plan my day in the morning, my entire day goes very fine. But if your purpose is to keep a track of your day, then it is in the end, I would suggest. Night may keep on your trackers and fill it in and all. Ideally, the best way is to spend 10 minutes in the morning, 10 minutes in the night. That is the max I spend. I make these spreads and then I just fill in. See, these are all blank kept. I only have to write in them. So it takes me 10 minutes a day in the morning. Morning, I come and see my goals. Evening, I just fill it in. So now we are done with the day planning. These are all the first spreads of it. Okay, we have not gone to the monthly or daily spreads yet. Right now we have a general idea of how your day will be. Okay, these are called monthly spreads. I know these look very creative and these look very, very attractive, but you do not have to specifically go with this kind of a format. I'll show you another format that you can do. Please do not get intimidated by my spreads or something. I know I tend to get overboard with the colors and all. A very basic one will also fill your purpose. So these are the 19 types of journal I keep. I will be talking about how the different types of journals and how I have helped them. So I was showing you basic spreads. So this one was made by one of my friends, and she was the one who inspired me, Deeksha. So this you can see is a very, very simple format. This was for my 2020 journal. very black and white. So you don't have to go all the way with colors. You can do very basic one. So don't get taken away by the amount of all this is accessory. Main spreads, like the monthly log, this monthly log I'll be teaching you right now to make. And it is basically, this is where you keep track of what is to be due, when you have an important meeting, when do you want to do something else, when is it and when it. Keep quotations. And these are more of these monthly one, habit tracker. I'm going to teach you how to make a habit tracker also right now. So this is a very basic spread. And as a beginner, if you are not really looking for more artistic and you just want to get stuff done, this is a very good format to go with and what I'm teaching. Apart from this, if you want to go in bigger, if you want to decorate one, this is right in front of you. And to be honest, this is also not very difficult to do. I just have... So this is very brown craft paper that came in Amazon. Nothing very special, no special paper, very special Amazon paper, ordinary paper you might have. If you are, I am a person who personally spends a lot of money on stationery, lot of art on stickers. If you are an artistic kind, you can feel free to invest in them. But personally, you don't need it also. So all these stickers, etc. Also, I tell you how to get them. I will be talking about supplies in the last part because that's the most boring part of this workshop, how to get these materials.
Oh God, that's the most fun part. What are you talking? You're talking to a stationery junkie.
I know. It's very boring to talk about it because it's just so much to talk about it. So there.
I know. It basically, you go down that rabbit hole, guys. There's exactly. No coming back. So don't go down that rabbit hole. Just stick with a pen and your markers.
I'm discouraging people from using washi. Once you go to the washi craze, you never come back out of it.
Yes. You just spiral down.
So there you go. It is that simple to do.
That's beautiful, Sachari.
All you need is black pen. I tell you, our tagline is finding Zen with a pen. That's it. It's just a fancy. It doesn't take a lot of time. You can follow a theme according to it. For example, this theme was Inktober ka theme. I did a lot of craft paper because I ordered a lot from Amazon. So a lot of brown paper was there. You can have a theme. You can go with theme stickers. Otherwise, you can go very colorful also. For example, the next theme was November. I decided to do with a yellow theme, flower theme. Go with your instinct. If you want to go black and white, go black and white. If you want to go colorful, go colorful. No stopping. Okay. But the main part is it needs to get the job done. You need to be able to fill your goals correctly in it and you need to do it. That's the main part. So goals we have designed. So we'll start with basic spreads like this. And then on the way, along the way, you guys can keep on decorating it and talking about it. For example, this is one of my other journals. I've been journaling for a very long time and it helps me a lot. So this was when I was in a colorful phase. I filled in with a lot of colors. This is a habit tracker I kept with my consultant. This is when I started these collages that I'm very into now. Sort of a vision board also. Blank pages. So you see, when you get interested in stationery, you buy all these kind of tapes and you never stop making these tapes. This was more of a junk journal. This was something where I just wrote about my life. I didn't really have any goals or I wasn't planning anything with it. It was just like, chalo, dekhte hain kya banta hai types. So this was another, this is a diary called The One. So for some of you people who do not want to get into the hassle of drawing lines and doing all this, this is a very ready-made planner. It's on Amazon. I'll share the link as well. It has pretty much all of this setup. So all these three achievements that I told you to do, my core values, etc. Everything is in this journal. If you are a beginner and you are more, don't have time to plan all this, or you're not a very creative person, this is the journal I'll recommend. It's for 900 rupees, I think. It is very comprehensive. It has steps and step written to what is it that you can do to journal. The only limitation is limited space. It doesn't give a lot of place for you to fill in creativity. So I could not fill in my collages, or supposedly I wanted to write more about a day. I did not have place to write about it. So, but if you want to, as a beginner, you're not very talkative like me, not have much to say, this is a good spread to start with. I will share this link of this diary as well with you. It is easy for, it is for beginners, so you can use it. Another of my journals was this. This was when I was going through a green yellow theme. This is also my COVID diary. This is how I changed my life. This was when I started journaling heavily, survived all my days of COVID. This was a health planner. So the theme and all, don't get carried away with it. All of them are basically habit trackers. All of them are essentially the same. What is important is what is to be done. So with that, let's make our monthly planner now. We have done with this. Let's plan something like this. Let's make a monthly planner. So again, you need nothing but a scale and a pen, pencil in the beginning for people starting. The trouble with having two artists in the house is stage stuff is always going here and there. So we start with basic boxes. I will be sending you templates for all of this. So you can take a printout of all these monthly habit trackers and all this also if you want. I'm showing you the difficult way, easy way, so you can do on your own also.
So are you saying we can use the template printout as many as we want, like 12 for a year maybe, and habit trackers?
Yes.
Cut them and stick them. Wow, super. Great.
I'll give you templates for this. All you need to do is just stick it, keep paste it, and take it.
Awesome. That's really dumbing it down for lazy people like me. Thank you. Sitting and counting the squares.
Hey, but there's a lot of, I started with templates, only made templates, but I started enjoying doing this so much that I shifted to this. Okay.
Some people do. Some people love doing this every time manually setting it up. It's like you said, no, a Zen thing, right? Becomes very repetitive after some time.
It gives you a lot of sense of control that, you know, I control my life. I'm planning my day to the D that I'm controlling my life. That is a very therapeutic. It gives me a lot of power to think of it. I'm basically planning my day out every day.
Yeah.
Let me see what is the January plan for.
Once can I ask?
Absolutely. Please do not ask. Can I ask? Directly ask.
Achha, because it will sound stupid, but how to keep a consistency of writing the journal like on a daily routine to have
we'll get that consistency? We will get there. Consistency is what I'm going to teach you.
That gets to my goal of being accountable. So yeah, you become accountable to yourself, Hannah.
It's basically, I'll tell you, there's no big, very big secret or something to do this. It's called a habit tracker. One of the things I will teach you is how therapeutic it is to tick off lists. So I'll show you, I'll explore Sunday. Okay, I'm making very rough ones for you. You people can fill it in later. So for example, I know Parama, Rama are here. They are artists. Use these part to use your fine lining skills. Use your Zen lines here if you have to. See? You are anyway.
We cannot see. We cannot see. Wo thoda sa wo rakha hai. Use
decay. Pull it into frame.
Yeah, I think it's in portrait mode. You need to have it in landscape.
1 minute.
Yeah, now we can see, but
like the camera is in the wall.
Is it okay now?
Yeah.
Yes.
The camera is vertical. It should be like this. That's what people are saying. Is that possible? Not the book. The camera.
Camera.
It's a little difficult. The screen.
Okay, then leave it. then don't ruin your setup, but wherever you're working, just drag it into frame for us.
Yeah. Okay. So anyway, I was doing with 0.5, you would not see the marks. So you can do your Zen line practice here. You can do a theme, for example, a butterfly theme. I'll show you a very simple pattern and theme that you people can follow. Don't limit yourself to design, creativity. Go as much as you crazy. In fact, I'm going to ask you in the end of the day to share your shares also. So one pattern, for example, you can do as a theme. You could do a theme with plants. This is because a lot of people are in my workshop already, art workshop. This will be easy for you to do. Just make a green blob like this and use your fine liner to draw florals. And it just becomes a theme. You could practice your florals also this way. And then it becomes just a theme. I will show you examples of this theme also. It's a very simple, basic design you can do. So Monday, Tuesday, you write all of this here. Then you make these small, where is the calendar? I hope some of you, at least, I know all of you will not be drawing, but some of you at least are making this with us.
Sorry, I'm not Sanchari. I took the lazy way and bought a ready calendar which had all these lines. But it is limiting a little bit for decoration, guys. But it gets the job.
Just fill it in. And that is it. Your monthly calendar is done. Just fill in the numbers and do it. There will be a couple of space like this left here. On this space, you can fill it with even more interesting ideas.
Yes, she loves the creativity or inspiring.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I'm going to inspire you more right now. After this, I'm going to ask Shaz to show her spreads as well. In fact, are the others, Deeksha here, I had a lot of people. All this has been taught by other people. I've learned from others. Some of my friends make amazing spreads. So it's from them. So now you can decorate it in your own way. Let me you can add in your stickers here. You can add in your creativity here. Go crazy with any format you want to.
Sanchari, can I just say a little bit about my journey with plants while you're doing that?
Absolutely, please. I want you to share your journey. I was not sure.
Not sharing as yet. Just want to tell them how I think of my planner. So guys, I'm 52, okay? And I jumped into this about a decade ago, 9 years ago. And let me tell you, it's been a great journey. You know how I jumped into this? I was Googling how to get over my anxiety and I was finding it very overwhelming. Different areas of my life are falling apart and I'm having to tomato everything and gather everything and plan. Okay? So what I did was I was looking at Google to find a way and then I found this planner community and it's such a gorgeous community. Of course, it's mainly made up of women because it's the women who jump into this whole decorative thing. But Saurav and somebody else who's a guy over here want to tell you that doesn't mean that there is nothing for you in it. So talking about how I look at my planner, I look at my planner as an extension of my brain or as my personal secretary. Do you understand? So what I do is, how does it help with anxiety? I'll tell you. Every day when you check in your planner in the morning and in the night, right? You plan ahead for the next day so you're able to sleep peacefully because it's not running around in your head. It's put down on paper. You have it actionable steps so you sleep peacefully. That's one way it helps you. Number two, in the morning, it gives you structure in your day. If you having tea, coffee, whatever, whenever you're building in the time to just check in your planner, do that and you will notice that you just run through, your list of things to do for the day. Your day is already organized for you. You've taken the trouble to do it the previous night. So it becomes much easier. And then what should be done? So it's not overwhelming. Now, when I sat and made my plan, how I thought about it, guys, was what are the broad areas of my life? Like she said, relationships, finance, career, right? So I said, which are the areas that I need help? One was finance. And I broke that down into what about finance I need to fix. Two was health. Definitely these two are the most important for me because that's where I was falling apart. Relationships, there's that much you can do. But for relationships, I was using it more to schedule social meetings, gatherings, etc. And I was using it to talk about relationships as in to vent once in a while. So I was using my planner for that. So these are the various places, you know, you will think, okay, I can use my planner. And then you break down your financial goals, as she said, into actionable steps. So in a quarter, I would want to save so much, which means it comes down to every week, how much must I save? Every month, how much must I save? At the end of the year, how much would I have actually achieved towards the larger goal of my life? So that way, the planner helps you. And guys, believe me, when you have it actually trackable and in front of you laid out in black and white, it makes your life so much more stress-free. Now, there is a downfall to this, guys. If you're someone like me who says, haan, likha hai na, ho jayega. No. It is you who has to go and do those actionable steps also. Just because it's down in your planner, it's not going to get done. You still have to go and do the dirty work. But the fact that you've written it down gives you at least you're halfway there. At least you know what has to be done and you've broken it down for yourself. So you're more likely to do it. Hena? The point now is to get more accountable, which is what she talked about, the habit tracker, right? One of the habits, check in your planner every day. That is one of the habits that I have down, along with walk, 2 liters of water. Have you taken your vitamins, right? Have you taken the dog for a walk? Have you checked your planner? Every day before going to sleep, check your planner. So there is my planner on the desk. And when I wind up work, I take it, keep it in my bedside. And then I go and have my dinner.
Absolutely. This is
At that time, I don't have any decoration, guys, because my objective is just to put down what I need to put down. Decoration, you know, when I do once a week.
Absolutely, again.
Even she does it before she starts. Like, you know, she's making empty grid and then she goes and fill it in. With me, I already have a fill-in grid because I'm lazy, as I told you. So I will do whatever I have to. End of the week, on Sunday, aram se, I'll sit up and, you know, I'll play with my stickers. Wherever I find gaps in my planner, I'll decorate a little bit. Because it would have already been written, but it's just going to look a hot mess and boring, you know. That's how I work. And trust me, having a little mini secretary of your own is awesome. I have a planner in a personal size. I have a pocket size planner and I have an art journal. This is my system of planning, okay? Different people have different systems. And then also you have sections. So you have a financial section. In the finance section, I'll have something for maybe, you know.
Can you show us, Shaz? It would be better if you could show us some of your journals. Like, speaking about it, I think people would rather like to look at it.
Yeah, you know, I used to be in a ring-bound planner. So all my pages from my last few years are all loose pages like this, you know. So unfortunately, I've not been very methodical in keeping them properly. But yeah, I used to have different. So I had page dividers like this in my planner with tabs, you know. The tab says, see, home. There's a me section, which is health. And then the finance section. So basically, these ring-bound planners are different, guys. It's they have these holes. They are, you know, these holes and the planner clips open and then you put in loose sheets of paper. So this is a different style of planner altogether. It's a little bit more expensive. I would not advise you to spend so much money on it because I've actually reverted to the easiest thing, which is basically this is my planner for 2022. I'm just showing it to you. It's very simple, costed me 600 rupees.
Wow.
Yeah, it's just so easy. This is a copy of a Hobonichi. It's a dupe. It basically has, so yeah, it has a vision board here. Like she's done, I've just written in pencil. What are the major visions I have? Financial freedom, more healer work because I'm a healer. I'm a tarot reader and a numerologist. A minimalist lifestyle. I want to maintain a Shamane journal and I want a healthy me project. So these are my penciled out goals. Now I will probably work on this more. This is how my monthly spread looks. What she's doing now, painfully drawing by hand, I already have here. Okay. So this is my month at a glance.
I've always wanted to keep a long planner, maybe next planner. I'll be talking to you about what planners also you can buy, which notebooks to buy. Lovely. Look at this beauty. Wow.
This is my week at a glance. Now it has a days of the week this side. And how have I done this is I put appointments on. So it basically comes like this as a long thing, but I drew a pencil line in the middle here. If you can see this pencil line. So basically appointments on one side and tasks on one side for the day. So like for Monday, okay, let's look at Tuesday. Tuesday at 5:30, I have a class which I've scheduled. Over here,
not very visible. Can you put pictures in the group? It's not very visible, actually. I'm not sure whether people are able to get the spread. Or maybe if you could get the phone like I have done, that would work.
It's not, I want to sorry, guys. See these but anyway, any idea? So this side is the weeks and this side is basically, this side is a page where what is the fun thing that I did that week? I think I disappeared.
Eight second. No, I'm trying to put only you so that it's visible. Anyway, Shaz, I think we'll look at more of the spread in a little while. I think
people are getting antsy.
Let's make something and we'll get back to you. I want to show all the spreads here. But let me give you options because you've talked so much about habit tracker. People will be like, what is a habit tracker?
Yes.
So one, this is done. This now is up to you, how you fill with your creativity. And this is exactly the first part of your task today also. I want you to make a monthly planner like this in your own theme. And the best theme gets a prize. I'm going to share what the prize is later. But now how to fill this to be more consistent. The first important thing you write is all your important dates for birthdays. For example, it might be, you can pencil it or write in ink. 12th might be somebody's birthday. Fill it into a birthday. Okay. Then for example, 2nd, I am traveling. So I write it 2nd. One very important thing that I measure here for 90% of the people, it would be very validate. It is a period tracker. You can use it to see, check your flow. This is how I remember to do it. Then any bills that are to be paid, for example, my Netflix bills comes at 28, right? Netflix ka bill. Okay, then one day of this.
Sorry, I had a question. Sneha here. So I generally use my Google Calendar for all this kind of tracking. I want to use, like, I also have a hard copy for journaling purposes, but I have a question. Should I also maintain this monthly tracker in a hard copy format? How does that, like...
I'm showing you the answer, Sneha. I maintain one here also. So if you can see my daily calendar for December and all, this is more based on the work part of it. This one I keep more for personal. So you can keep your work stuff here. What meeting is there and all this can stay here. But for the personal one, I suggest you use this type of a format because I'll tell you why. It helps me rate my experience as well. What went or what didn't. It helps me write more details. Calendar, that kind of calendar usually helps you, what do you say? Deadlines. It is useful for deadlines and reminders. But for this, I would suggest this is a better way to do. For example, I'll tell you, every Sunday, I want to keep one alternate Sunday for art. Okay. And one alternative is for my date nights. We fill in one for this. Personal relationships also need time. So date, you write this, right? Then there are other things that you can fill in. For example, art and all I have scheduled. Skincare. For example, you can keep 3 days a week for skincare, you can fill it in. You can as along go ahead, color code it as well. You can color code it for a specific team to see. So like if I've ordered something on Amazon, I put that here. If I'm attending some workshop, I put that workshop here. Sometimes I use stickers to talk about how my day went. Sarojini market I went, I write that also. So all of it, this really helps me see, not just right now, later when I go, it helps me realize what I did through that year. Okay, so it's more easier to fill it this way. Then after the spread comes the, this is a spread that is optional. It is a little complex to make and it is, it requires a lot of planning. So the future log is essentially what you will do. It is an extension of what I had taught you that time. Where is the January, February one? So remember I told you about this, you fix your goals into this. The next step of this comes in, let's break into even further logs. So you do it more monthly wise. This you can do it in a bigger spread. January, for example, mine was workout. So you put some milestones to it. Keep by 21st. You can mark a date here. 21st, I will do this. I will lose 2 kilos or I will clean eat, whatever it is. So you use this for a future log planning. And I suggest that these ones, this area is for the highlights of your life. So every day, every year, after every month, I finish something called the reflection one, where I write about how my month was, what was the specific highlight of the month. This is what you could use for it. For example, February, maybe the highlight was Valentine's Day. You can fill in Valentine's Day was my best day. This just stays as a very good place to see all how your year has been mapped through the day. So this again, I'll send you templates for this. Okay, now we come to, so apart from this, other spreads that you can do is one separate spread I do for exercise. This is only my exercise diary. So how many calories have I burned that day or what kind of exercise I write in this. It helps me be very, so somebody asked how to be accountable and how to be regular. It is the satisfaction of seeing this. When I see these khali khali streets, I'm like, I did not do much. So it is the satisfaction of filling this every day that will keep you consistent. Every day you'll come here and you'll mark your things. Every day you will write what it is done. That is consistency. I am telling you that at the 21 days is what it takes to become an habit. You get addicted to such kind of an addiction. You want to fill it in this every day. So then comes this posting schedule. This is for people who are trying to do more of art. This is since I'm an art teacher and we teach art at Arare, this is more for your art inspiration. So everything that I want to draw comes in here as a brain map. So some of you people must be using Pinterest. This is sort of my offline Pinterest board. For example, lately I've been wanting to do monsters. So I write monsters here. Okay, at the end of the month, I can check how much I've done, how much I've not done. Okay. So now we come to monthly spreads, weekly spreads. Weekly spreads are very interesting. Weekly spreads are basically, these are the most convenient ones and the most that you are going to use. Okay. So let's make this again, very simple. All you need is a scale and you divide your page into basically 7 parts. You can do it into 8 also because Monday is an off for me. I sometimes divide it by 8. I'm doing rough calculations for now. One part that I have not talked much about is the spiritual part of it. I believe a lot in the power of manifestations, power of vision board. So I cannot live my day without an affirmation or, you know, saying something positive. And I'm obsessed with being grateful. I practice. In fact, I'm going to teach you a gratitude tracker also next. I think gratitude makes a big part of all my dreams have come true because of the gratitude I offer. So I personally spend a lot of time writing my affirmations. For example, even this, there is an affirmation space that I've kept. I'm going to write my personal affirmation in it. So this is this basic planner. What I have left this place is for a very good reason. This column you see is for what went right. Shaz told us, Shaz was showing us, right? Something about it, what went right. So something, for example, Tuesday, you had a great lunch. So I had a great lunch. And this one is for what didn't go right. What is it that kept you troubled? Maybe you had mood swings. Maybe you were up all day doing social media. You write that here. Okay. This place below is for your finance calculation. So Monday, you could do all your, you can add another line here. you can do how much, what is the money that you spent in here. Maybe, you know, you paid some loan and all. You can put a sum to this. This is where you put your money tracker in it. This bottom line could be for reminders. You will have a section here. You can, this is completely your section. I have chosen two types of sections here to do. So in the beginning, I started doing my finance here. I started writing my finance and my goals here. I've also tried meal planning here. 1 week I tried doing meal planning and all this here. Another week you can do is a habit tracker. So I have been talking a lot about habit trackers. What are habit trackers? Habit trackers are basically therapy. Once you get into the habit of filling and looking into habits, they help you become consistent. Okay. So what are habit trackers? You can do with something like a simple habit tracker like this, or I'm going to teach you how to make a habit tracker by scratch also. But essentially what you do is you keep a track of everything you do. I made you write an idle day, right? This is my idle day written in steps. So first is wake up early. So all the days that I wake up early, I click on it. Second is my lime water. Lime water is done. Third step is gardening. I want to water a plant. Then intermittent fasting is something I follow. So there's a tracker for intermittent fasting, no sugar, no tea, exercise. So you divide your day into these concrete steps that you want to do. I have highlighted the ones that are most important to me, like ordering food, eating salads, no sugar. And then I have marked it in this. So this is the therapy part of it. Every day you'll come up and at the end of the space, spend 10 minutes filling in. When you see empty lines, you will automatically feel, yaar, maine toh kuch kiya hi nahi. I need to be more regular. I need to be more consistent. If you don't want to... What?
Sorry. I just interrupted. So is this like we are documenting everything in a large sheet, but then compiling it and seeing it as in a data sort of a way? Like,
exactly. You see it as a data. So you see the trends in it. You can see how many days in a month were you consistent. When you see this at the end of the day, you'll be like, oh, end of the month, maine sirf 30% kiya hai. Next month, you will automatically want to do better. And this is for you to introspect also. So for example, one kind of habit tracker is this. So it is the same habit tracker you saw there, just more advanced here. Okay. So I can see that the things that I lacked most was this one. So 8th, I didn't do anything. The thing that I have most trouble doing is intermittent fasting. So you can keep a log of it. It is basically going to see, bullet journaling will not solve all your answers. You filling the bullet journaling every day is going to fill your answers. So every day, so
basically, you have to, this database is most important, right?
It is a form of data. This is the form that worked most for me. I'm going to teach you and tell you next about the kind of journals you can keep only. This is the form that has worked most with me. I'm going to share many options with you. You can choose to follow anyone you want.
This, guys, is the funnel down result of your whole thing. So it's like, think of it like a funnel, right? You have the global overall year view, then the month view, then the week view. This is your daily tracker, which actually talks about where you're spending time and what you're doing. And initially, you might have 30 habits like Sanjari did, but now she's figured out that most of it becomes second nature for her. She really needs to focus only on skincare.
Exactly.
And maybe, you know, the second brushing of the teeth, which, you know, she seems to miss out. So, hey, after like 2 months of doing this, you will say, I don't need to have 30 habits to track anymore. I've understood most of it becomes second nature to me. The areas from my data grid, the areas that look more gappy is, you know, these 2-3 habits which I really need to focus on. So next month you'll probably make a shorter, smaller habit tracker with fewer, like, just I would say just try and track 4 or 5 big habits and do small changes, right? In a quarter, try and change one habit 21 days, and if that becomes a habit, then next quarter you might say, okay, brushing teeth is no longer something I need to track anymore. There's something else I need to track. I'll incorporate that instead in my tracker. You know, something like that. But it does help you. It helps you.
Brilliant. Absolutely. See, if you can see this, I have put a habit tracker. This was my step counter. Every day, how many steps do I do? And this used to be my habit tracker. So this becomes a whole data for you to analyze. I mean, it looks pretty, but most importantly, the function of it is to understand what is it that you are lacking. For example, some habits I don't track anymore at all. I don't need to track them. I've got so good at it and doing, I don't need to track them. So that is why start with a lot of habits, but gradually you will understand that all that not all of them are worth for you. So first month you are doing this, give it time, you'll get it to it. And I'm going to help you plan all this also. So let's get ahead. So I want to show you something.
Because you're filling in your planner, going to your planner should be like, you know, a personal date with yourself. Like you said, you have your own little annexy to your brain here, right? It should be fun place for you to go to, not to beat you down ke yaar itna maine kiya nahi. So, you know, it should be fun and it should be something which becomes second nature and quick for you to fill also. It shouldn't be 30 habits I have to track every day. No, initially you had a whole bunch of, you know, the whole yard list of everything that in your life you wanted to do. But then you realize that actually doing few at a time helps you maybe more. Maybe you're that kind of a person.
Absolutely. And I have told you had a very one. Start with limited habits. Don't go for all of them at once. At the most, you should. This is
Sanchari, a big... just a question.
Yep. Who's asking? Disha, right? Isha.
This is Isha here.
Yeah, Isha, tell me.
Isha.
Batao.
Okay, this is a question very off everything that we are doing. I firstly wanted to ask you, is journaling all about tracking only?
Absolutely not, Isha.
I think my expectation from the class.
No, Isha.
So my expectation is slightly different because this is something.
Isha, no. The second part is all about different kind of journal only. The first part is about how to plan. Now that people have an idea, now what she's showing you the video will make more sense. Don't worry. It's all about different kind of journaling. One type of art journal I keep. I keep around 18, 19 types of journals. So you got to get there. So for example, this is more of a personal journal. I used it to give it to my partner for his 6th anniversary. This is more of an art-based journal. This is where I keep my memories in it. This is more scrapbooking like rather than more of planning. There's a lot of things to be done. So where I wanted to tell you now is let's finish with this spread once and then we'll go it. So habit trackers, I told you. I want to share with you some certain different types of habit trackers that also I've kept.
I think you when you see the daily pages that she does, you'll understand more how she can incorporate journalism, journalistic style while she's doing her daily, you know, pages.
Yeah. You will
get a better idea, Isha. And there are different kinds of journals. This is a more a planner style to you know, be accountable and get things done, which is why people have 2-3 and multiple planners for multiple things. So this is one kind of planning. This is an analog style of planning. Then there is, of course, the bullet journal style, which you can incorporate into this. And then there is a purely fluid, flexible art journaling style, which she also does. You know, some people do a marriage of all three styles in one book.
I used to do exactly that. I used to keep one journal for everything. And then I realized that more than the purpose solved, it was just getting me more confused, which is why I subdivided into the journals. And the second part is all about this only. What are the different kind of journals you can keep? Not just this one. Just trying to look for one particular file here. Yes. Just one second.
You know, I used to get muddled with my own personal tasks and my office tasks. So that's where the Google Calendar idea really helps, because then there's a clear segregation of what I will track online and what I'll track in my analog planner with, you know, my own writing. So there is no confusion there. Some people like to use the same journal. They draw a line and they say, you know, this is personal tasks, this is official tasks. So the daily pages will reflect, you know, a half and half kind of a picture. So it really depends on what works for you. It's a little bit, the whole journey is the fun part, Isha, you know, trying different things. And the best thing, guys, is you don't have to answer this to anybody. It's your own private little thing going on with yourself. It's your own, you don't have to show this to anybody. It's a highly private place for you to, you know, get your life in order and get yourself into shape, into what you want to be. Get to that place that you want to see.
I totally understand that, Shaz. The thing is, there was so much of planning and formatting I see out here, and I've been a control freak. I have been there, done that. Now I'm in a position of life where I want to let go of all this planning.
Absolutely.
I want to understand how can journaling help me in that way. I don't want to get into planning and detailing and tracking my day to the end. I want to get out of this. So I'm waiting for that.
Isha, I can get out Isha, of this hi,
planning
Isha,
and can detailing and get my unconscious.
Isha and Shaz, can you just guys have a look at the screen? That is exactly what I'm trying to tell you right now, is how to make different kind of journals. We started with planning because that was what it is. Now you can devise to the different kind of journals that you can keep. I hope my screen is visible, right? So I have kept around 18, 19 types of journals. So we are going to talk about the different kind of journals. Journals don't have a specific purpose of only keeping track of it. It is a very big therapy. I don't know, Isha, if you're familiar with Soul Flow Art, but our entire business is art therapy. So our more focus is on art journal, but we realize that both of them can be combined. So for example, this is one of my earliest journals. It's a memory journal. I did not write in it every day. This journal that you can see was mostly for special days. If I was a young kid, then this is, I think, my journal from college first year. So I would just fill in things like some quote that came in mind to me, some newspaper clipping, this flower from a memory. It was a very pure memory sake journal. So letters from people, some autograph I got. This is a kind of journal you can keep, just keep your memory sake. For example, if you are a greeting card you want to keep or something, you can keep it that. The other kind of diary I keep is more for the people who are studying, etc. This is more an educational fact. This is my facts and GK diary. I used to be a very big quizzer at a time, and I used to love collecting trivia. So this is the kind of diary where you can write in your trivia, you can write in your facts, educational diary. You can keep a doodling diary completely. That has to be no theme, nothing. You can simply fill in it as much. I was a big doodler at one time. I used to carry my pens everywhere. So this time, this diary was of real use to it. I would write poetry. I would just do, this is called junk journaling. It needs no format, no lines, nothing. You can just draw anything you want to. For example, this is a card that Saurav gave me in 2014, and I still have it preserved. See, Saurav, this is why I keep memories. Then there are art journals. Yes, the first time you and Arushi had sent me cake. I am obsessed with memories. Again, these are higher GSM journals. GSM is a very important part when you come to journal. GSM basically ensures how thick is your paper. Because this is a watercolor journal, you used to need to have a special watercolor journal to have thicker papers. This is 180 GSM and above. This is from a page called Doodle Dabba, social media page called Doodle Dabba. This is a reading journal that I used to keep. So very interesting thing about this reading journal is that it helped me read. I used to read 100 books a year. Okay. Then I went out of habit and I stopped reading altogether. So when I went to MBA college. So one of my reading that I'm going to have a habit this year is my reading list. So this format is very useful for reading list, I personally think. So it is a bookshelf, as you can see. You can simply write the books that you read here, and also you can add a star to it. So for example, the next book might be Profit. So you add 5 stars or 3 stars to it. If you want to take reading even more personally, even more higher level, you can keep a reading journal of what book you have read. What were your top reflections? A famous quote from the which you liked. Stars, how much would you rate it? And day of ending. So if you really want to make reading enjoyable for you, this is a very good habit of doing it. You find it very enjoying to fill and write. It helps you remember the books also, your giveaways, etc. Since I am a person who reads a lot of self-help productivity books, this exercise really helps me keep in track of what are the things I want. This journal is from the Big Book Box. I don't think it's in continuation anymore, but I had a lot of fun filling in this. See, your goal and purpose can be anything to do. It might be wanting to maintain. This might be interpreted as I want to keep track of things, or it might be something just for reflection. You choose it. This is a travel journal. You can keep a travel journal since there are artists in this group. A travel journal is great if you want to keep down your memories and draw. So for example, the journal I use now, I travel to a place and I sketch that place also and I make a small notation. It helps me, I don't know, it makes me feel good about my day and all. Niranjan, can you show, get the happy journal, the daily purpose journal, gratitude journal. This is a very personal one. I don't like opening it because it's very embarrassing. It's a love journal. I have a new version of it now. But it is something like you want to put your vision, you want to write a letter to your friend or something, you can make it in the form of illustration and sketches. So across all this part, I have collected, the mind brush journal. Yeah. So this is something, a journal you can keep and maintain to give to your partner. These are again, these are these handicraft journals you can get in front of Sarojini or in front of any hill station you go. These are very easy to attainable things. Then the next one is my gratitude journal. This gratitude journal is something that I write only my gratitude in it. I write only things I'm grateful for. I have made so many lists. In fact, one of your, since some of you asked if this was only for tracking things, no. This is also for you to feel a lot of introspection also. One of the sheets I'm going to ask you to fill is 100 things to be grateful for. My first is internet only. So you can fill in, and I want you to do this. Once you start writing the things you are grateful for, everything else falls in place. Sometimes we tend to get very negative. We tend to get very moody. This is when it helps. What are the things to be grateful for? Okay. So yes, I will share all the links with you. Okay. Then
I don't know, Isha, does that answer your question partly? Do you want to know more about?
Then this is an art journal. This is an art journal that you can keep. Art journals, I have kept a lot of them since most of you are artists. Here also, there are two ways to keep an art journal. One can be a thematic one. For example, this was, I planned to finish it in October. It was my Inktober journal, okay? Another thing you can do is junk journaling. So here you can put a practice into it. One of the things I'm going to share at the end of the class is an art journal itself, a ready-made template for art journal, which is going to be basically a Zen guide you can just fill in and work with. So I'll show you how you can be regular here. For example, here there's a whole calendar made here where I made what practice to do each day, what to draw each day. Then there are mind prompts here. For example, I drew the screen. And then I wrote about my feelings about drawing it. I always track my mood through it. I'll show this towards the end. So there are, art is one of the biggest things that you can keep in journal for, obviously, because it helps you keep, it makes you be more creative. So this is an art journal. This is again a watercolor journal because it needs watercolors, as I said, need a harder paper rather than ink and all. This is one of my first earlier planners. Like I said, you can see that they are done in very simple ones. You don't need fancy stickers or anything. You can simply use it to track your days. So this was my September, October one. Then this, the next journal one is a special motivational kind of a journal. I used to write all my motivational quotes and affirmations in this. So you can keep a journal different for your affirmations. This is a very interesting one that I strongly suggest people to take. It's a vocabulary journal. I write new words, new phrases, new things that I, new terms that I learn in this. It really helps me remain fluent with my English even now. I love learning new words. I love learning new languages. This has my Japanese and French work also in it. It's really beautiful. The next journal that I'm going to show you, it is one that has been that I gifted to. In fact, this journal has become the most beautiful of journal of all. This used to be my journal, but now Niranjan uses this journal. I gifted to him the same journal after using it much, and now it's filled with his drawings. So these are the best journals. These are called GSM paper. These are very good journals for your ink sketching. Parama, etc. I would suggest you get this size of journals. Mini pocket journals are very good for tracking, for keeping pen illustrations and all at sake. Okay. Then this journal is just beautiful. I've added just because it's beautiful. It's made by Ruskin Bond. It's got very beautiful. If some of you are wanting to make it for poem and are poets, or you know just want to keep on with storytelling, there is no better journal than this Ruskin Bond journal. It is just beautiful. I'll show you the Ruskin Bond journal. It has such beautiful creations. In fact, I gifted it to my dad, and he's a poet. He loved this. If you are looking for an art-based journal, if you're looking for something to write your thoughts in, beautiful Ruskin Bond journal. This is a daily planner. This is a pocket planner that you can keep, that small pocket planner just for your daily tasks. So every day that you need to do, this is a small planner. This is not very practical because you'll need on keep on shifting to new ones every month or so. These are small, but if you are on the traveling, if you're a consultant, if you're on the job, that's a good one to do. This journal you've already seen. This is the minimal journal that I used. In the starting, this is a Lectum notebook. I'll give you the link of it. It's a 750 rupees notebook, very good quality. One important thing is your pages can, you know, bleed in it. So that is why a good journal is always recommended, a good journal and pen. Okay. So this is a very smooth paper. I'll suggest if you want to create a journal from scratch, go with this size. My size is slightly bigger. I won't recommend that. Go for a smaller size like this. All right, then this is a...
What size is it? A5.
So this is more inspiration for you guys.
Hang on. When you said good quality paper, you're going to
180 GSM. 180 and above.
Can I say above 100 GSM? Because sometimes 180 is fully watercolor only, right?
My pens are a little bleeding worth. It's completely up to your pen. The first thing that I do in my journal is to take a pen test. Completely up to you. This is now basically, guys, I'm just inspiring you people with themes. You could do a planet theme. You could, if you're a watercolor, this is my weight tracker theme. So everyone is a goal step, as you can see. As I go by, I click off the goals. It just makes the weight loss more interesting for me. This is a list called the 28 before 28. So every year before my birthday. So this is for people, if you do not have your January, birthdays in January, February, you can do something according to your age. For example, I'm 29. I'm going to do something called 29 before 29. I'm going to give myself a target of doing 29 things. For example, solving a Rubik cube, or, you know, for example, running in a marathon. It's just fun to do along the way. You can also see the designs that I've done. They're very minimal. I just taught you this design. This is called a reverb design, I think, where you just draw something and you draw a flower on it. It looks very attractive. You can try this method also. Lot of the things I use in my workshop before I did it was sticky notes. See, I taught you how to do this time. You can make a whole theme out of it. This floral theme, what I showed. So you don't have to worry about aesthetics also. You can make a very minimal theme. You can divide a page into 3-4 days. This is a typical diary you'll get on New Year. Just start writing anything. Then this is, of course, the best journal of all, the one I have already showed you. The journal is called the One Only Habit Tracker. I'll send an Amazon link to this as well. It is a complete diary. If you use this diary, you wouldn't need workshops like this. You will just need, you'll just need this for begin with. It's a beautiful diary. You can color it, decorate it according to your way. This is my meal planner. I use it to plan my meals. So what food is it that I'm going to eat? What day am I going to eat? How much calories are in the food? That is how I do. You don't have to go that calculative as well as to how many calories you eat. But if you are planning to, it's a good way. Workout one is also where I keep my workout tracker and all. This is my planner. How many steps have I walked that day? How many calories have I burnt? The page next to it is an intermittent fasting tracker. So the green line is how much time I eat. What is my eating window? And the yellow one is my fasting window. So it helps me keep a track of how many days, on what hours am I eating on. And it looks pretty. I just made it because it looks pretty. It's not very functional. Then this is again a meal planner. I use sticky notes to write what is in my house currently. And then I make plans accordingly. To Monday to Friday, what plan can be done with what ingredients I have. So these all can be taken off using a Dutch door and you can just write it. So that's it. That's the kind of planners you can keep. Apart from that, meal planner is a separate journal for me. Meal planner is a separate journal for me. You can keep all of it in one page. Like I showed you, you have. So this journal is from something called the Jotting Dots. Jotting Dots is the only Indian workshop that I've found that, which has these good quality 180 GSM's notebooks. Everything here you can plan into this. All of the things you can, I keep my meals planning here itself. What am I going to eat? What I'm going to do? Everything you plan in one. You can either do it on a different page or you can use the same page. Apart from this, there's this one planner that I really love this year. It's called the Mindbrush Journal. It is not a journal as such, but it brought me very close to my gratitude practices. Every day it asked me to practice my gratitude. What are the three things that I'm grateful for today? And I just sort of became very attached to this journal. It's a 66-day transformation challenge. If you are not looking for any career progression or such, and you just want to become a better person at peace, this is a very good journal because it starts with talking about what are the different aspects in life you can change. And, you know, it gives you a motivation talk every day. So it becomes your accountability coach as well. And at the end of the week, it asks you to reflect. So I had a lot of fun filling this. If you're looking for some gratitude practice, if you want to learn how to get closer to your spiritual being, this is the journal you need to keep. It has changed a lot of way I think and feel about myself. And now for the freebie part of it, I'm going to give you a free guide. I'm going to give you this free guide, which not only, I know not all of you are artists, but I think ABCD, anybody can draw. So I'm giving you this book, which is basically going to talk about how to use art to become more consistent. So every day, it's a 21-day challenge. Every day there's going to be a new kind of challenge, new kind of drawing to make. There are a lot of practice affirmations given here. Lot of art planning affirmations are given here you can use. Then there are these guided lines that you can draw.
Can you zoom in team Soul Flow wala?
Is that fine?
No, zoom in like two screens are there.
Fine now?
Yes.
So for example, there are these rat illustrations there. So I practice doing it. Art has a lot to do with my consistency because my first thing that I said, first thing in the morning, I need to do something. Mine is to do Zen lines. So every morning I make it a plan that I spend at least some time doing art, and art changed my life, which is why I completely changed my career, everything, to become more associated with art and to help people get through it. So if there's one habit you want to, I can't, even if you're not artistic, is to get into more of art into your life. It really will transform your life. Okay. So now that we are done with the different type of journals you can buy, let's plan with something else. If you don't want to buy a journal, what to do? Okay, so habit tracker is one thing I really want to focus on because habit trackers are very important, okay, and it keeps you consistent. So let me teach you what you to do after this workshop, okay? You don't need my help also. You need just a slide called Pinterest. All you need to do is go to Pinterest and look for journaling inspiration. Journaling inspiration. So here you will find so many options. You will go crazy looking at themes, shortlist some themes, find some good ones. You'll get ideas to do it. You can do a blue one. You can do a pink one. You can do a happy planner. So you will get a lot of themes here to do from. Choose a theme and stick to it. Okay. So this is one thing. If you want a theme, you can get a theme from here. Apart from this, the most important part why I do journaling is habit tracking. And habit tracker has changed my life. So you can make something as plain like this. I'm also going to give you I'm going to give you templates for habit trackers. So you don't really have to make your own also. But if you want to make your habit tracker, we are going to learn how to make one. So again, habit trackers can be as creative as you want to. For example, one habit tracker that I used to keep can be in the form of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Spotlight. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, you can keep all your dates here. Okay, this is prompt I really like. Here you can write the habit. For example, first habit is not use phone. So for the first day, if you not use phone, you use this. Okay. Then if 17th you use this. So this becomes into a, it becomes into a colorful and interesting format to fill it in. You can, all the days that you do, you can fill it in. Or if you don't want to do this, you can fill it in this form. This becomes more creative. Okay, so write your habits on this end, the date, and just fill it along as you want to do. Another very formation of habit trackers is a mood tracker. I am a personal, personally, I'm a person with a lot of anxiety, with a lot of mental health issues. So I plan to keep something called the mood tracker. Is it clear? Yes. So what you can do is write all the number of days in it and write about your mood. Is it great, fine, sad, tired, or anxious? Then there are two ways to fill it. Either you fill it in like this, or you can use dots. For example, I felt fine here. I felt nice here. I felt here. You can use it. I felt low here. I felt very low here. I felt low here. Then you can simply use to do this. So you'll be able to, at the end of the month, get a graph of how your mood fluctuation was. Okay. Apart from this, some other spreads that you can do, it depends basically on your priority. What is it that you want to change in your life? For example, if this anxiety or mental health is an issue, you can do something called the year in pixels. Let me show you what year in pixels is. Year in pixels is basically a way you can use to track your entire year in how it is. So now you know why I talk so much about goals in the beginning, because if you don't have a particular goal to go on with it, journaling becomes a tough. For example, see, this is a life year in pixel thing. I'll give you a downloadable format of this. All you need to do is just fill it each day. So by the end of it, it becomes a whole colorful parade of what you have done. And you can see your year in pixels. Was it good? Was it bad? It will somehow be filled with this. Therapeutic, right? Just looking at this makes me want to, you know, fill my diary every day. So these are the various possibilities that you people can do and you have to do. So I talked about a bit about that art journal. I talked a bit about my 21 day thing, which is why this is the time when I'm going to tell you about accountability. Somebody asked me how to be accountable. So far, I have not found any accountability ka issue other than a key solution. You have to get a coach, because I started doing gymming on my own. Nahi hua mujhse. I started doing art on my own. Nahi hua. What really works is an accountability coach, which is why me and Niranjan this year decided to open something called the 21 day transformation bootcamp, which is essentially going to be 21 days with us. So we are going to give you a gift of a new consistency life. We are going to make you plan for 21 days different things. For example, this is about art, but so much more than that. Week one we will be doing these. Week two, we will be doing this. Week three, we will be doing this. But much more than that, we will be giving you a consistency. Every morning, I'm going to ask you to spend 15 minutes with me, either planning your day, either writing bullet journal prompts, either, you know, introspecting, because big part of this is introspection. I will be asking questions like, what is it that you want to be transforming today? What are the three things you can change in your life today? Let me, in fact, share with you the schedule of it. So if you want to become consistent and if there's something you really want to change in your 21 day in January, this is what I would strongly suggest. This program has been made especially for people to get them into this whole art into it. If you start your January with a bang, trust me, the entire year will be amazing. It only needs to be, you just need to get the fuel running. Which is why I wanted to do this today, because by the time January 1st is there, I want you to fill up, I want you to make all these sheets by now then and practice it from January. It isn't that tough, is it? Is this workshop tough, people? Did you have a tough time following this? Did anybody find this tough to do? unmute and tell me also, was this tough to do? Is all this planning and thing that I did?
Not exactly, Sanchari, but people like me. People like me who are not used to using or writing much, you know, we are nowadays more used to keyboards and tapping on that and all. So for me to just to start a journal, I mean, bam, you are so creative. Just the flow of it was so overwhelming. I was like, oh my God, there's so much we can do. But I haven't even started. So somewhere I felt lost. So
I understand.
It's not tough to do. It's just that the beginning phase had to be there and to start writing. Pick up a pen and to start writing. Nowadays, I feel strange even when I'm writing something on a paper, even when I was taking down notes. It's a different feel. So absolutely. Yes, holding a pen and doing something right now for people like me who has not been doing it for a very long time, it kind of is a challenge, but yeah, obviously doable.
But Isha, this tick that you put, no, is so therapeutic on paper when you make a list and you are clicking it like this. This is the most therapeutic part of it.
See this, guys, this is the tick she's talking about. I have this is my finance section in my little pocket planner. I have a tick against different headings of my bills. So when I pay the maid salary, January, so-and-so amount, I tick. It helps organize things so much. This is one of my little planners. So the tick really helps you.
And also something to do with your hand. You know why gardening is considered the ultimate form of therapy is because you are getting in there and, you know, doing it. That is the same with journaling. I have experimented with every kind of journal, the ones that are prepaid. I just have to populate them. I have tried online journals also. I used to keep one on iPad Procreate. But it just didn't work for me the way this form of writing and do. Now I'm just so loose with everything. I don't have a pressure to write. For example, today I wanted to write about my Christmas yesterday. So simply all I did was yesterday we had done a workshop, my classmate, we did a Merry Christmas scene. So now it's prepared. I'm going to put the old monk and the wine bottle that we had at the party last night. I'm going to make a spread with this here. Just the experiences, a small Polaroid of what had happened. Merry Christmas, that's it. I have no pressure to especially write how my day had gone, what it is. It's just free for me. And since I travel a lot and I have weird experiences with people and all this really helps, like reflections, just writing about what the month went on. See, for me now, do you realize this? For me, I have a whole year of planner done. December 31st, I can look at my year revive. I have a whole year with me. And that is the magic of this rewinding thing and all. So, and coming back to this 21 days, so I have shared the syllabus with you. It's going to be a 21-day class where day one, I'm going to teach you the how to draw a wave. Second day, I'm going to teach you how to make your wish list, how to write your affirmations, how to do it. By the end of this 21 day, I promise that you will not just be a better artist, you'll be a much, much better person. I've dropped the link in the group. Everybody needs a hobby. You know, without hobby, we would just be animals. Hobbies are what keep up doing. So whether be it reading, whether be it art, whether be it drawing, whether it just be stand-up comedy itself. Have a hobby, guys, and find time to do everything in this. That is how I managed to find right this. Write an ideal day, make time for ki this hour I will do art no matter what, this hour I will study no matter what, and everything can be done. Hi Sneha. Hi baby Sneha.
My daughter joined. She's been doing the artwork on the side, so she wanted to see her face. That's why.
Hi baby Sneha. Soon you'll also have to plan and journey.
She loves craft, art and crafts. So when she saw all my stationery stuff out, she just wanted to join in.
Adorable.
So cute. So now comes the homework part. I'm not leaving you without some homework and the goodies part also. So two things that I want you to do for me is design a spread. No, it doesn't have to be fancy like mine. It doesn't have to be extensive, but at least do a month at a glance spread. Create a layout like this. Just do it. Just see it 1 month. You have tried a lot of things, right? Try doing it once. Try doing this method once. Make a small. I'm going to send you so much reference to do. Draw it and share it with me. How do you share it? I'm sharing the credentials for this. How to share and how to do it. Just share it. And in return, I will give you these amazing template sets as well as something very special that I made for you. Wait, let me show you. so many windows are open, these Zoom calls are very tough to do. I have so much more respect for you, Niranjan, now. This is very tough to maneuver.
And we get gifts as well, Sanchari. What fun.
What fun? I'm sorry, I didn't get it.
I said, what fun, we get gifts also.
Yeah.
You're giving us something. Yeah. Sanchari, tell me when you want me to share. I haven't finished sharing what I have as yet.
I'll just finish with this and then it's all open for you people to do.
That is if, of course, the gentry wants to see my lineup of planners.
I am sure everybody wants to get inspired. In fact, if there's anybody else who's making and all also, please share with us your spreads and all.
I wanted to share for Isha to see because mine is mainly the style that she's talking about. It's very free flow. And
can you fix your screen though, Shaz? I mean, we are not able to get it very clarity on what to see. Can you fix your screen once? That would be really great.
What's wrong with my screen?
Really? No, visibility is very low. Can you find a way to show us more clearly or send pictures in the group? I will
send pictures in the group also. Sure.
Absolutely. And I want all of you to share what you did today, what you are working on, stickers, etc. in it. So the last part of the session is coming. I'm giving you homework. After homework, we are going to work on materials. I'm almost done.
By the time you're searching, I have one thing to ask. The thing you were talking about, love journal. So I have been thinking about making it since like more than a year, but I could not find the right paper size and right material and the right kind of tracking to do it. So if you can just help me a bit with that.
Like, okay. We all have our own agenda of like, I want it to be about my art and my habit thing. So like specification customized for each of us.
Right.
Can you just give that?
Absolutely, I'll talk about this. So first of all, guys, everything, draw something, make a nice spread and tag, mention me on IG, tag me. I'll be dropping my links also, how to tag me. Tag me and one of the best results from you, one of the best spreads from you will get a chance to come for the 21-day bootcamp for free. Right now it is for 2022 for all attendees, but the person with the best bullet journal spread, apart from Shaz, because I know she's good at it, part of 21-day bootcamp, gets a chance to be with me on this 21-day bootcamp. Apart from this, you can, of course, do it. Now, let's go to your question, okay? Simran, let's go. So the best things for something like this, when you do a project, personal project and all, I would suggest is going with these little diaries. Okay, Menorah, this is by Menorah Stationery Diaries. Let me share my screen and show you these diaries on Crow, on Amazon itself. Okay. So Menorah is a very good brand for non-watercolor stuff. This will hold on to your color. And in fact, even for watercolor, so far I've not received any bleeding as such. I've been coloring water. So this Menorah mini journal is something that I would strongly suggest you to get.
I think this is the same brand.
I think so, yes. I think it's the same brand. So this is these are lot of Menorah products are very good. No matter what workshop you want to start with, I will suggest that you can start with Menorah. So where is the, I think the smaller size is no longer available. So you can start with these ones. These are very good ones because if you don't like a page, you can tear up out of this also. So I will suggest tum isse start karo. This is a very good journal for making these diaries and all. Apart from this, pens is something that people use ask me a lot. It's a slightly expensive pen, but this is so far the best pen that I've got. These come under these sets of dual brush pens. They are so far the best pens that I've discovered. They don't bleed easily. But if you don't want to invest in something as expensive as brushstroke pens, go with those gel color pens, go with it. Just do a swab test before you bleed your notebooks. First do with a sketch. I would suggest in the beginning, if you want to start with something called the brush dual tip brush pens, because you will need them for both of this. So these pens essentially have behind and this, I use hash tip pens. They have worked with me for around a year. There's a thin liner also. There's a fat liner also. Both of it you can use. Okay. I also showed you about the journal called the One Journal. So let me show you the best journals. If you search journal options, how to select the best journals, okay? You do a Google search, Instagram search, there will be so many of it. One thing to go for is the GSM. 80 GSM is very low. Do not go for 80 GSM. You will not be able to sketch anything. So don't find it. Find Your Balance is a very good journal for people who are looking for more gratitude practice, more of mental peace. Apart from that, these journals, again, handcraft journals are very difficult to draw in. So if you are planning to draw with it, don't go it. If you're planning for collages, go for this one. Collage ke liye, this is the best. Apart from this, lectern. And don't worry, I'll be sharing all these with you.
Yeah. It would be quite helpful if for each kind of journal.
Yeah, I'm just sharing this with you taki aapko bhi agli baar naam, you want to search for your own one, you'll be able to do. Otherwise, I'll be sharing all these links with you. I have a compiled document of links and pen. I'll share it with you in today. Factor Notes also is a very good notebook to begin with, but they will not work with watercolors and all. If you're just using a black and white, that orange diary that I showed you in the beginning was from Factor Notes, was this drawing one. Very good size to work on again. So another brand, I want to introduce you also to a brand, which
is the Factor Notes one, the plain one without any...
Mine is dotted. Another thing, thank you for reminding me, you will have options of dotted, plain and ruled. I will suggest not go by the ruled, because ruled mein lines ke saath fill karna is mushkil, but go for a dotted journal. My journal right now is a dotted journal. Dotted journal is just more fun to work with. Okay. Now bring out your Instagram, because there are a couple of pages I want you to follow so that you can understand more about journaling. First is, of course, me. You need to follow me so that you can tag me in all your posts and I can see what you are drawing and all. Second is, of course, Soulflow Art, which is my company and how we do art. So I want all of you to tag us in these posts that you make and all these shares. Okay? The one who wins, I will be choosing out of this only. Or tag us, I will be choosing the winner here. Okay. Apart from this, there's a brand called Jotting Dots, which is my favorite brand, because this is the only brand in India that is giving high quality one. Okay, so Jotting Dots is one page you right now follow. Apart from Jotting 10, there is bigger...
Wait, what is Jotting Dots for journals, right?
Very good planners. Nobody in India is making 180 dotted GSM so far. I have to... Archer and Olive is extremely expensive.
Very expensive.
That is why this is the best. The other option is Bigger Dreams. Bigger Dreams is for if you want branded journals, if you want really good quality journals. They also have very good stationery. So if you are looking for investment and quality materials, Bigger Dreams is where you need to go. And if you are not really looking for quality, but for just stationery, Journal Say Shop. It is the stationery version of Shein. So here you will find a lot of supplies. In fact, see all these spreads you can see. You've seen a similar spread for mine, right? So this is from all these stationeries are from here. You can get all of your stationery needs, your stickers, etc. here. First time I went there, I spent like 2,500. So be cautionary while you go here. You might be spending a lot of money more than you think. And if you're looking for something economical and something to begin with, I will suggest go to Washi Sabi. Washi Sabi is per person. She has these kits for planning. So you can just reach out to her and ask her, I want to start journaling. Can you give me a kit? So she makes these small samples of this and she'll give you a small kit to begin with. So all these things that I've made in her class are from here. Isha, you wanted to know about journaling, right? One of my journaling is this technique. I draw something in it and the next to it, I make a collage with it. So this is a form of art journaling I also consider and keep. It's a little hectic to do, but I love doing it. I have done it for Caravaggio, for Baskets of Caravaggio and Wave of Hakusai.
For these collages, how do you get these pictures and all of that?
Journal Say. Again, this sticker is from Journal Say workshop. These tapes are from Washi Sabi. I have a huge collection. Even though I'm traveling, I've collected all, I've kept all my stationery here. So you have to collect stationery on the way. All these links I'm saying are stationery only. Washi Sabi has all these stickers. Then Journal Say has all these stickers. These are all sticker brands only.
So you have a more detailed workshop on art journaling at some point of time, which you will do, I guess, where
I want you to conduct one on this art bullet journaling workshop next on these collages and etc.
Why not? Where we've broken it down into steps, you know, how to do it. Isha, I think that will help because you seem to be somebody who's more logic-driven and more methodical. So it's not very difficult to do. It looks overwhelming for sure, but it's not so difficult once you know what the process is. Like, you know, you can just simplify it for yourself. So once she's finished, I'll show you what I do and then maybe you might get an idea.
Yep. And I am almost done.
Sanchari, which was your first, when did you first journal? When did you start journaling first?
I think
the first journal you started with?
Class fourth, fifth. I still have all my first journals kept. Although those are very stupid and make me feel very
creepy. So what exactly was it that you started with? What was it?
I would just write it,
not the art part. I can totally understand your art part, but
I use Jersey when I'm
so what was the matter which went to it? I'm trying to understand what goes
the thought process behind journaling, right? You want to understand the thought process behind journaling, right? So when I started writing in third, fourth, I would just draw in simple. My eighth class, say when puberty hit, those are those really embarrassing journals talking about how my crush didn't look at me today, how my friend did not talk to me today. I brought this for lunch. Then it started. It was around 9, 10th when I started doing it for studying. Now I just do journaling to what I feel like. Just buy a notebook, Isha. Just buy a notebook and do whatever comes naturally to you. You will find your style within 5, 10 days. Spend time with it. It will come to you. You can keep some, maybe in a while it feels like you want to do poetry with pictures. Maybe you want to write a line of poem and associate a collage with it. It will just come to you. Just spend some day, the blank page, fill it with anything you want and you'll get it there. All right.
The idea is to have fun and to want to.
I'll take less than 2 minutes right now.
Absolutely.
So the thing is, the kind of life I have lived in last 2 decades is it's very planned, very methodical. I've been a corporate person, manager for a very long time. Now I'm in a phase of life where I'm letting that go, letting the changes happen, because I have been a control freak for such a long time. I really don't want to get into any kind of planning and, you know, documenting. My mind itself has become something like that, that if I decide tomorrow I have to do this at this time, I don't need a journal for that. But what I want to do right now is I'm trying to get into a lot of, I'm reading a lot of books which are into tapping mind power, you know. So I'm recently reading Dr. Joe Dispenza's book.
Ah, I love it.
And I want to start journaling because I want to get in touch with my subconscious mind, actually. Somewhere where I can understand, because working in corporates for such a long time, I think I'm very highly aware of the conscious thoughts that I have, so much that I can plan without, you know, kind of writing down or anything. But I want to get in touch more with my subconscious part, for which I want to start journaling. And I'm absolutely clueless right now, Sanchari, how to start it, where to start, what to write, what to follow, how should it look like. So my point of view to join this session was not to understand how journals should be designed or made. I was very, very more looking into the matter which goes into it. And frankly, I'll be clear, but I am still at a loss of it, how to start.
Okay. Isha, I get
so
it.
I wanted to understand what was it that you started with and how you write.
You are putting too much pressure into making a journal. If it is not coming to you, don't do it. That's what I'll say. If there is no need for it, you are trying
abhi
to
samajh mein nahi aaya ki jata kya usme.
Because you are trying to create a need. You are trying to
banane ka to hai hi nahi, likhna kya hai.
So I felt a need to create and express, that is why. But I'll talk to you personally. I know what kind of mental block you are doing. So many people do it. I'll get in touch with you. I just want to spend a couple of time saying about the power of vision and manifestation. Everything that I've achieved in my life this time, you can see, is something that I've written and I've followed. If you make a vision board, and this is not the scope of this, but I strongly suggest everybody to have a vision board in front of you. When you take it out there, when you spread the universe the message, that is when it comes to you. It is something you, not all of you might believe in it, not all of you might persuade it, but it does work. So I believe in a lot in the power of manifestation. I believe a lot in the power of asking for things. So I would suggest all of you make a vision board at least. If there is one takeaway, one thing that you want to do from this workshop, is to plan out your goals, write your vision and express yourself. If you don't know what you want in life, nobody else can come and define it for you. So I want all of you today to that goal exercise that we did it, spend some time with it. Also, I will be giving you this one. This one, I usually am not making you do any mehnat for it. I'm going to give you as a free itself. It has got a lot of steps on how to build your affirmations, how to build your journal, how to fill in it. I've given a prompt also. You have to just fill in the blanks for this. Then you can pick out affirmations. There are a lot of habit trackers I've given you and themes, things to draw from here. I'm going to add in some more habit trackers because most of you people asked me about habit trackers. So I'm going to share all this with you. It's going to keep you motivated for a pretty long time. I'm going to send you these printables also. I'll send it to you by Wednesday, I think. And you can start drawing. Now I'm all about the questions.
They have some questions.
Hi, Sanchari.
Yeah, sure.
Hi, Sanchari. I have one question for you, one pressing question. Mm-hmm. So, buying a journal available in the market, suppose the best one, okay, versus the one which I make on my own, what would you say, according to you, what's the difference? And since you've used both, how is your experience? How would you compare your experience using both of them?
That's a brilliant, brilliant question. Thank you so much for asking me this question. So it is completely on to you. You know, in the beginning, I'll tell you, you start doing I have followed Alicia Souza planner. My first planner was Alicia Souza planner. I have followed Tiny Change planners a lot. After filling it for a couple of years, you know, a couple of months, no, you yourself will feel like it is not fulfilling my all goals. I need to put in a personalized, customized goals. It's the same like gym ka example dete. If you go to your gym on your own versus getting a coach, if you do it on your own, you will not be able to, you'll be a little lost, but you get more stuff done. So I've dropped a link for the one that you're talking, Tiny Change Planner also. You can get a planner by it, but I'll personally say khud ka karke dekho. If you are a creative person and you have time, make it on your own. If you don't have time, if you just want to be regular, buy a planner journal.
Yeah.
No other option.
Okay,
the results will be same, Isha, results will be same. Because habit tracker is something that is in this planner also. Habit tracker is something you are also making. Result will be same in both.
Correct. And did you mention a planner for somebody who is I want to gift a planner to somebody who is not into journaling, who would, I think, start using journaling to solve maths questions. is there a basic level of journal that you can suggest?
The Tiny Change planner. I've dropped a link in it because it has all prompts in it. You don't have to do anything with it. It will just tell you on its own what is to be done. So even if the person is to just read in it, for example, Isha, you are having a problem, right? What to write? It will tell you, write about the biggest achievement you had this year. Write about 5 things that fuel you up. Write about something that makes you happy. You have so many prompts. You'll just fill it in.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. But is that, I was thinking the Tiny Change is quite overwhelming for a person who has not started journaling yet. Is it?
No. There was the one or something, blue one.
The blue one is, it comes in brown now. The Tiny Change is also coming in. I think it will be okay. Isha, it comes with videos and all also. I think it's pretty comprehensive. I think people can do it. Mm-hmm. I have gifted to so many people, Shweta Kapoor, so many people, so friends of yours mm-hmm. also. Everybody's loving.
Okay. Okay, Sanchari, thanks.
Actually, I have used the Tiny Change planner and after doing this workshop, I actually realized, yeah, the reason, the exactly what you mentioned, I felt it is restricting. And so then I used to like kind of deviate into just normal notepads for a few days. And then I was kind of getting lost because I'm not able to fully capture everything that I want to in that Tiny Change planner. So today I realized, I think the way is to just have a blank canvas and then define what you want to do, what you want to track, and that would be the
absolutely best. Absolutely. Because there were a lot of things in the Tiny Change that you don't want, that don't make sense to you also. So this is just customization. But again, if I had taught you this before it, you would not have understood also. So Tiny Change helped you get into what is done. So if you want to start with Tiny Change or start with your own template. Both work, guys. Okay, now you can show, Saj. I'm done with my part. Now I'm taking all questions, guys, and get inspired. ask us questions, share with me whatever you want.
Please ask questions, guys. I'm very happy to show you. So this over here is my pocket planner. This is also my wallet. This is what I carry every day with me. Okay. Now, if you open it, it's got these rings, right? And different pages. It's of course got a section for. So it's got this sheet here which is protective, and then of course I have stickers over here in a pouch which is stuck here.
Sanjari, can you can you pin Shaz so we can see her in, or do I need to change my view?
Yeah, lighter. You're breaking a lot, Shaz. Can you? Shaz, go ahead.
So then see the back has got a wallet, and of course there are cards over here, credit cards, vagaira. There's a loop for the pen. And the main thing for you to note is that I have sections, okay? So I'll take another one of those which already has the sections which I've set up for January, okay? So it's gray. I have a dangly thingy for decoration. Decoration and all is just extra. Don't require, okay?
Absolutely.
What you need to note is these tabs here. If you can see, I have like a monthly tab, a weekly tab, and then, you know, I have a tab for... to-dos, right? Just the to-dos, the list of things to do. Then I have a tab for finances. I call it money here, okay?
Ma'am, where did you get this from?
I made it. So these are different. So that's what we were talking about. Once you jump into this rabbit hole, there is no end to the amount of stuff you will start procuring. So before you get, so this is what I used to do before. This is what I've collected over time. Okay. I don't suggest that you go out and buy everything. Start off with just basic.